गुड मॉर्निंग गर्ल्स, दिस इज़ डॉक्टर किरण देशवाल, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इंग्लिश। टुडे आई विल टीच यू द स्टोरी माय बिलेव्ड चैरियटियर कंपोज्ड बाय शशि देश पांडे। इन यस्टरडेज वीडियो आई हैव टोल्ड यू अबाउट दिस स्टोरी एंड अबाउट our writer Shashi Desh Pandey. In that video we discussed that Shashi Desh Pandey is a feminist writer. She writes about female issues or issues of Indian women from middle class. In this story we have three characters, Aarti, Preeti and the grandmother. The story reveals the bond of affection and love among these three characters, the relations which they share. So let us start. I smile as I hear them at last, the sounds I'm waiting for. A rush of footsteps, the slam of the bathroom door, and then bare feet running towards me. In this paragraph, we can understand that here the author is describing the activities of a child. Whenever we have a little child in the house, we always wait for its activity and we always wait to spare time with him or her. I smile. Here the grandmother is narrating this story. I smile. She smiles as I hear them at last. She smiles when she hears the footsteps for whom she is waiting. A rush of footsteps, the slam of the bathroom door, and then bare feet running towards me. By this description, we can guess that the child Preeti is coming out from the bathroom and the grandmother is waiting for her. You should not bang doors that way, I say reproachfully. Rebuking her, the grandmother says that she should not have banged doors that way. You might wake mummy. So mummy is here Aarti. Aarti is Preeti's mummy. So the grandmother is ordering her not to slam the door so loudly because the noise can wake up her mummy. She sits opposite me, cross-legged on the low wooden stool. Preeti is a child, so grandmother also keeps a low wooden stool for her, suited for a child, hair tousled. She has bathed recently, so her hair tousled, cheeks flushed. Oh, she won't wake up for hours yet. The child knows that her mother will get up late, she says cheerfully. It gives her a feeling of happiness. Have you had your tea, Ajji? She addresses the grandmother as Ajji. So she asks, Preeti, the child asks that, have you had your tea, Ajji? This is a part of our daily routine. I can never confess to her that I have had a cup an hour earlier because it can hurt the child. This is her joy that I wait for her. Preeti feels happy when she know that grandmother has waited for her so that they can have tea together. So in these lines we can understand, we can guess that how much deeper the bond is between the grandmother and the granddaughter. They share their emotions, their feelings, they share their tea, and they start their day by having tea together. No, I have been waiting for you. Have you brushed your teeth? So, see the conversation. When adults talk to children, the conversation is also same here. Have you brushed your teeth? The grandmother asks to the child Preeti that have she brushed her teeth. She makes a face. I will do it later, she says, trying to be brisk and casual. She is reluctant in brushing her teeth. You will do no such thing. Go and brush them at once. So, grandmother is grandmother. She is ordering the child, go and brush your teeth first, then come later for the tea. Only today, Aziz, from tomorrow I promise I will brush them first. She pleads, she requests that let me drink the tea first. Let me have the tea first. From tomorrow, I will brush my teeth first, then I will come for the tea. Nothing doing. I try hard to be firm, but I can't fool her because you can't be strict and rigid with your child, with the child to whom you love so much. She lowers her voice to a conspiratorial whisper. Mommy won't know. She's sleeping. The child is saying that my mama will not know that I haven't brushed my teeth. This is a secret between us, and from tomorrow I will brush them first. Now, of course, she leaves me no choice except agreeing on her suggestion. I have to insist. She goes reluctantly and is back so fast, but the grandmother insists on brushing, and the child goes and comes so fast. I have to ask. Then the grandmother have to ask, and did you really brush? You have come so early, so fast. Did you really brush properly? Show me. Look, I have to smile at the grinning impi's face. She shows her teeth. Now tea for me, milk for you. Ultimately, as always, we compromise, and her tea is a pale brown. Always. Tea is harmful for the children, but they are stubborn. They say that no, we will have tea. So parents have discovered a middle way. They give them half tea and half milk, so it becomes pale brown. I switch off the primers, and without the hissing sound, our voices seem loud and clear, because at morning time there is silence in the environment, and whenever we speak, the voices become loud and clear. We look at each other guiltily that Aarti, Preeti's mama, might have heard this. Thinking of the sleeper, and try to speak in lower tones. Happiness can mean different things to different people. Very beautiful sentence. Happiness have various meanings. Happiness is always different for different people. Someone feels happy when he meets with his relative. Someone feels happy by sparing time to his near or dear one. Someone feels happy if he have good food or delicious food. So there are various ways when people feel happy. For me, for grandmother, it is this. The beginning of a new day with this child. This is the happiness for the grandmother. The beginning of every new day with this child, with the sweet talks of the child, with the sweet accents of the child. We talk of many things, but too soon it is time for her to go to school. Bathed and fresh, she sets off. The child leaves for the school, and the grandmother lives alone in the house. What happens next? We will see in our next video. Thanks for watching.